This is your life. This Harrods, London, and the lady I'm hoping to surprise has popped in here to do some shopping, but not for those crumpled stockings she made famous. She is, in fact, just one floor above us. She came down to London thinking she'd left these pals of hers in Birmingham. Famous faces all, but I've no time to explain now because we're expecting a signal that she's finished and is about to come down and press for the lift. Now, it's very essential. If we're out one split second, if we get the wrong lift, you can imagine I'll be going up in this lift and she'll be coming down in the other, and we'll never meet again. So I gather it's time to go, so let's all get in the lift. I'll get as far back out of sight as I can. All right, well, that's the signal. Now, onwards and upwards. And I can assure you, we're going to be the last people in the world she expects to come tumbling out of a lift here in the heart of Knightsbridge. Here we go. Well, now, this couldn't have been on the shopping list anyway, could it? No, it couldn't. All your friends from Crossroads are that we can say to you. Tonight, Kathy Staff, this is your life. Ronnie Allen, Sue Lloyd, Stan Stennett, Sue Hanson, Paul Henry, and all at Crossroads. They really did surprise you out of that lift today.
Oh, they did.
But, Kathy, somebody else without whom tonight's surprise would not have been possible. You thought he was at home in your home in South Yorkshire, but, of course, he's here. Your husband, John. No. And John's not alone, Kathy. With him, your daughters, Susan and Catherine, and Catherine's husband, David, and your sister, Constance, with her husband, Derek. Kathy Staff, this is your life in real life, a wife, a mother, an actress. On the screen, a woman of many parts, including, of course, that maid of all work in Crossroads, Miss Luke.
Was I glad when they told me this morning they'd taken you on?
Oh, not half as glad as I was last night. And I've moved over to Miss Tatum's.
Oh, good.
Yeah. Well, I've just about finished in here. Where to next?
Kathy, because our television fiction has taken so factually, as we were in fact talking about, Crossroads for Millions is a real motel. So it is all the more a tribute to your special talent that you have us believing just as deeply in Nora Batty, the saggy stocking sex symbol in Last of the Summer Wine, here very much heard but not seen.
Bed one at each corner. Come on, jump to it.
Yes, well, here we are. What's a fool going to think with all these men in my bedroom?
Oh, well, if you keep quiet about it, Nora, we will.
Lift, now. Lift, that's
a... Quiet, this is some sort of bed, is this?
Oh, you need some stamina for a bed like this.
Bill, was it as enjoyable as it looked doing that last scene?
I don't think it was, actually, for Kathy, because she was stuck under that bed for a long time.
I was.
I thought she'd nodded off. But I revived her. You hold my glasses. I gave her the compo kiss, which she prefers to her husband. Come here. Oh!
Kathy, we've all very much enjoyed your work in comedy and in drama, but there's yet another side to your talent which you displayed just recently in the cause of charity. In fact, at a gala concert in aid of the Association for Spina Bifida at the Theatre Royal Drury Lane. News cameras caught you rehearsing.
Try standing on the corner, watching all the
Crabb, this is your life, and you were born in Astley Street, Duckenfield, near Manchester, and named after your late mother, Minnie Higginbottom. Oh. I take it that you later decided that for an aspiring young actress, the name Minnie Higginbottom could be improved on or shortened.
Yes, definitely.
Here you are on a family holiday, nonchalantly strolling along the Blackpool front at just 3 years of age, yes? Your late parents were both keen amateur actors. Here they are in Gilbert and Sullivan's Princess Ida. And you make your first stage appearance at just 4 years of age in your local church pantomime. Aged five, you start at St. Mark's Church School, Duckenfield, and a year later, there you are yet again on stage, this time a pantomime fairy. Next, it's Lakes Road School, then a secretarial course followed by secretarial work, where you're able to carry on with your acting with a company which was called the National, but not the National, Kathy.
No, no, it was the National Gas and Oil Engine Company.
Well, the National Gas and Oil Engine Company Amateur Dramatic Society staged the play This Happy Breed, and at 17 years of age, you played the grandmother.
That's right. Granny Flint.
Granny Flint. Now, John, you were training to be a schoolmaster when you met Kathy in 1949. Where was that?
Well, we first saw each other actually in church. When she was 21, she came down to my hometown, Llanelli in South Wales, to join a touring repertory company. But we actually met then, actually, when we had a youth club dance at the Christmas time.
Well, Kathy, you and John become engaged at Christmas 1950, an event which softens the blow that also at the end of that year, the rep company has to disband. That was 34 years ago, Kathy. Now, when the company disbands, Kathy, you turn your back on an acting career, return to Manchester and take a job as a secretary. You and John are married at St. Mark's Church, Duckenfield, near Manchester, on August the 18th, 1951. And 5 years later, you give up your job to concentrate on being a full-time housewife and mother to Catherine and Susan. Then one day in June 1960, quite out of the blue, you get an invitation to dinner that turns out to be an even more important one than you could have guessed. So I'm a young actor who also began his career with that touring rep company. He can't be here tonight, but if you look at that screen, we're going to hear from him now. He found television fame as Hadley. Of course, Gerald Harper.
Hello, Eamon, and hello, Kathy. Eamon, first job I ever had in the holidays from RADA. Got £2.10 a week, was in a rep at the end of the pier at Sheerness, where I had the pleasure, in a play called While Parents Sleep, of making love to Cathy in a diaphanous negligee. My Sam Brown belt got inextricably mingled with her nighty, and we rolled off the sofa, unable to part. That was a long time ago. 10 years later, I was up at Granada doing television, and I dug Cathy out from Ashton-under-Lyne, where I met her husband, and found that she'd become a housewife. Well, by the end of the dinner, we changed all that. And that set her back on the course that made her the star she is today. But Kathy, I've had a lot of fun in this game, but I've never enjoyed myself more than rolling about on a sofa.
Thank you, Gerald Harper. Well, Kathy, with your interest in acting renewed, you start getting small television and film roles, among them in 1962, the part of a caring neighbour in the film A Kind of Loving, in which Catherine, who was then just six, also appeared.
Come along, Catherine, now it's time to come in. Come on, there's a good girl. Bring your bicycle.
I'm locked out. You don't know where they've gone, do you?
But they've gone to the hospital. Didn't your mother ring you up? It was just after 2 o'clock, love. She fell down the stairs. Come on, Catherine, there's a good girl. You don't know anything about it.